When dealing with TOS or thoracic outlet syndrome, two of the common areas of impingement tend to be the pec minor and also the anterior scalenes. So as a REMEX for those, we're going to do a stretch for each of those muscles. I'm going to start with the anterior scalenes. Do it where you're sitting on the edge of your bed, works, or in a chair. For the purpose of here, we'll be on the edge of the bed. We're just going to be sitting up straight. And for the stretch, what you're going to do is you're going to, so for stretching the right side, we're going to laterally flex to the left, which is going to start the stretch of the anterior scalenes. And to fully target those, we're going to rotate ipsilaterally the head so that the stretch comes into the anterior scalenes. And that's a stretch you want to hold and maintain for 30 seconds at a comfortable, not painful position. Once that's 30 seconds, you're going to take a break and then you're going to do the stretch again. So that's the one for anterior scalenes. So it's a lateral flex away and then with the ipsilateral rotation, so looking back towards the side you're stretching, you're just going to target the anterior scalenes on that side. The second stretch is going to be for pec minor. So with that, while you're on your bed, what you're going to do is you're going to lie on your back. And then lying on your back, you're going to lie on your back so that your body is right over to the side, so that the side you're stretching, the arm can hang off the table. So we're going to use gravity to aid in the stretch. So as we're lying on our back, what we're going to do is we're going to bring the arm up straight. And then we're going to bring it out straight at 90 degrees. And then we're just going to abduct to about 110. And we're going to allow gravity to take over and maintain, which is going to provide that stretch to the pec minor muscle. Once you're in a position that's a good stretch, you're going to hold that position again for 30 seconds where it's comfortable and not painful. Once 30 seconds is done, you're going to bring it up. You're going to rest for 30 seconds, and then you're going to go back into the stretch. So we're instructing our client to do the stretches for the thoracic outlet syndrome. We're looking at the two stretches being pec minor and also the anterior scalenes. So starting with the anterior scalenes, we're going to focus on the stretch on the right side. So with that stretch, client is sitting up nice and straight. They're comfortable. So we're going to laterally flex away. So you're going to laterally flex to the left, which is going to initially engage that anterior scalene. Then to fully target, we're going to ipsilaterally rotate, so looking back towards that side, we're just going to engage that anterior scalenes, feel a good stretch with that. And you want to hold that and maintain that stretch for 30 seconds. Once you've held it for 30 seconds, you'll take a 30-second break, and you do the stretch again. So, so positioning is key, is that you want to get that full lateral flexion first, so bringing that ear to that shoulder, keeping the shoulders relaxed and the shoulder down. And then you want to get that rotation to that same, to that side you're stretching, which is going to engage the anterior scalenes properly. And that's going to maintain that stretch. The stretch for pec minor, you get your client lying down on their bed, something where their arm can hang over the edge, and use gravity as an aid for the stretch. So the arm that we're stretching is this side, which is one that's over the edge of the bed. So we're going to bring the arm up straight to begin with. What we want to do first is we want to just come out, keep the arm straight to 90 degrees. Once we're at 90 degrees, we want to add that abduction to 110, and then we just want to let gravity take over. And do you feel a stretch with that? Good. Once they feel a stretch and maintain that stretch, you want to hold that for 30 seconds, breathing as they're doing it. Once the 30 seconds is up, you're going to take a break. They take a break for 30 seconds, and they're going to do the stretch again. The gravity helps to elongate, and it also aids in increasing that intensity of the stretch to make that stretch a deeper stretch. Again, the stretches can be done twice a day. We're doing that every day of the week.